Hello, this is Bern, and on today's episode, I'm going to be revealing 7 signs that the guy you're into, the guy you feel chemistry for, is wasting your time. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your greatlifetobe.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, heart-centered, and successful women like you how to attract the kind of quality man you want into your life as a result of being the most feminine, radiant version of you. No need for gimmicks, manipulation, crazy pheromones, or weird techniques. Now, being in a relationship, attracting your ideal soulmate and life partner is as much about finding the right guy as it is about not wasting your time with the wrong one. I've shared many, many times through my videos that attracting unavailable men is not a problem. Spending time with, wasting time with unavailable men is a problem. So first sign that the guy you're with is wasting your time, provided you're looking for a lifelong commitment and partnership, is he is not asking too many questions about you. He's enjoying spending time with you. He's enjoying your presence. He's enjoying your light. But he doesn't really feel hungry to get to know you. In part, he really doesn't care. He just wants to have a good time. In part, because the more he asks you questions, the more you'll ask him questions, and he may not even know the answer or not want to answer them. So that's the first sign that the guy you're with could be wasting your time. Second one, he is inconsistent in his pursuit. If he doesn't clearly know what he wants, or if he doesn't want something serious, he's going to show up once, disappear, show up a couple weeks later, get you all excited, and disappear. He's hot and cold. He's playing games, not necessarily because he's mean, just because he's not hungry enough to clearly stand up for truth and pursue you the right way. So that's the second sign, inconsistent in his pursuit. Number 3, he's evasive. That's a kind word of saying shady when asked what he wants. Or he's the kind of guy that plays it as he's so cool that he hates labels, right? It's not that I don't want to commit, I just don't like that word. Why define what it is that we want? Why talk about the future if we don't really know each other? That's clear code for I don't want something serious, I just want to connect with you, potentially have sex with you, enjoy your greatness, but not really put my heart, my soul, my emotions into it. So if a guy is not clear about what he wants, or he's giving you the runaround, or he's playing as if he hates label, that's also a sign that most likely he wants something different than you want, and if he's not, he hasn't grown up enough to tell you the truth, which in either case, that's not the type of guy that you want. Number 4, he is the type of guy who pushes for intimacy without any strings attached. He's the type of guy who hasn't spent the time getting to know you, giving you the security that you need to know that you can open up more without risking unnecessarily, without playing emotional Russian roulette with him. He hasn't taken the time to be consistent in your life, to maybe go through some good times, some bad times with you. He hasn't followed through in action, in dates, in communication between dates, but he feels like he should actually test the waters and have sex with you so that he can continue. If he's the kind of guy, I'm not saying that there's anything wrong with a man for wanting to have sex with you, but if he's pushing for it and he's not hearing no for an answer and he's actually trying to shame you and make you feel bad or make you feel like you're too tight or you're not open enough or you're not fun enough because you're not willing to have sex with him without any strings attached on his part, then ask him to go kindly F himself, okay? That's the kind of effing he'll get with himself and only with himself. Next one, I think it's number 5. He doesn't mix you with his life. Now, it's clear that at the beginning of a relationship, this beginning of a dating process, you're not going to meet his mom and dad and friends and the whole thing. But if you've been around for a while and it's basically a silo, you see him and then his life is an unknown, where he lives, who he spends time with, friends, family, he never mixes you with his life. That's another clear sign that he's wasting your time because he's probably hiding you from them, or he's maybe not even excited about the kind of life that he has, if he has a life at all. Next one, number 6, he's coasting through life. He doesn't have a clear sense of direction. He doesn't have clear goals. He doesn't have a sense of drive. He doesn't have a sense of enthusiasm for something bigger than himself, for something that allows him to wake up early and sleep late. He's just doing? I'd say, what do you want? What do you see your? What do you see yourself a year from now? I don't know. What do you want over the next 10 years? Just be happy. Nothing wrong with him wanting that. My guess is if you're a woman who's watching this video, you want a guy who has a clear freaking sense of what he wants, what he's going for, and is willing to put in the effort in his own life so that he can provide that kind of energy around you when you're together. Seventh, he pulls away when emotions get higher. What does that mean? You have a deep conversation and that's the trigger for him to disappear for a week. Or you feel like he was a little bit more open with you and he gets freaked out and he stops texting you. And you text him maybe once or twice and he fails to respond, especially if you know that the trigger was something deeper emotionally, something where he either opened more, you opened more, something more physical contact happened. If he's the type of guy who pulls away when something gets better, another clear sign he's not ready for a relationship and he is wasting your freaking time. Now, if you find that these signs are helpful to you, I'm gonna ask you to do three things, my dear. Number one, first link in the description of this video, you're gonna find a way for you to sign up for a free masterclass that will show you step by step how you can create the kind of relationship you want with a lot more flow and eliminating pain. That's step number one. Step number two, like this video or thumbs up. Step number three, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already and click the little bell to be notified of new episodes as they come out. Last thing I want to share with you right now. Today was a great milestone for the channel. We hit 18 million views. So I have to thank you from the bottom of my heart for being someone who shows up, who likes my videos, who comments on my videos, who shares with friends. You make my life so much more meaningful. And I'm so happy and grateful to be a small part of the progress and the growth that you have in relationship to loving yourself and loving men in a different way. Send you all my love and look forward to connecting with you soon.